Hello everyone, welcome back to illphocorphics. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to turn any face or model into a whitening effect, also how to create this kind of flyer in Photoshop. I will show you all the necessary steps so that you can know how you can also turn yourself or model image into a whitening effect and create this kind of awesome looking flyer. If you are a designer and want to know more tricks to create a unique looking flyer, this tutorial is for you. Watch the tutorial until the end so that you can learn how to create this effect and flyer. If you are interested to learn more about graphics design and logo design, you can check out my channel Showfic Design. I create professional graphics and logo design tutorials for everyone. Hope that you will like my tutorial. And if you are new to my channel, be sure to subscribe and press the bell icon so that you get all the notifications of my channel and never miss any chance to learn new tips and tricks. So be sure to subscribe and press the bell icon. Now, let's start today's tutorial. Now we are here in the magical world of Photoshop. I have downloaded this image for today's tutorial. And if you like to download this image, just check the link in the description. I will give the link to download this image. Now first what I'm going to do, go to the toolbar and take that crop tool, and then go to the options bar and take the 4:5 ratio size for our document. Now adjust the image properly and make the crop perfectly and place the model face and also the area perfectly into the document. Hit OK. Take the move tool. Now select the layer, go to the adjustment layer, take the solid color. Choose white color and hit OK, put that in the bottom and select the model layer, create a new blank layer, then go to the toolbar and take the brush tool to choose the white color and increase the flow 100%, then also decrease the hardness of the brush 0%. Now apply the brush to the bottom area of the model. Then go to the adjustment layer and take the hue saturation. Now we're going to decrease the saturation to make the image black and white. Take around -80 or -90 and that's okay. Next, go to the adjustment layer again and take that exposure. In here we're going to target only the offset and the gamma correction for our effect. Adjust that and try to follow my step. Then again go to the adjustment layer and this time take the level adjustment, because you can see this image is too much white. So we're going to decrease the white by the middle point of the level adjustment. And that's perfect for me. And you can see we've just created the whitening effect. Then select all the layers and create a group. Change the group name into anything you want. We need to do some change to some area only to our model face and also the floor area. So apply a layer mask, then take the brush tool, be sure the foreground color is black, and take the flow around 20% or 30% and remove this area. Take your time and do that like me. Then go to the adjustment layer again, and take the vibrance, decrease the vibrance around 0%, and also decrease the saturation around 70 to 80%. Then again go to the adjustment layer and take the curve. Now do some color correction with the curve adjustment. Now we are almost done, and you can see we just make our model into white and you can see the whiteness effect. Next, create a blank layer. Then go to the toolbar and take the brush tool to choose the white color and apply the white into the hair area. Take the flow around 5 to 4% and apply this black hair area. Select the layer mask of the group and try to adjust the effect a little bit again. Also decrease the effect into the eyebrow and this area. Take your time and do it perfectly as you can. Now you can see we're almost done. And you can see it's perfectly looking that effect that you are targeting to get. Now for the final effect, we need to do some editing into the camera raw filter. And you can leave it with that effect if you like, but I'm trying to make this image more perfectly and make the effect more dramatic and professional by looking through the camera raw filter. So first, we need to create a snapshot from the bottom of all of the layers. So press Shift plus Control plus Alt plus E to create a snapshot. And if you're using the Mac, press Shift plus Option plus Command plus E. Now you can see it creates a snapshot. Next, convert the layer into a smart object. After that, go to the filter and then camera raw filter. In here, do some of the color correction with the basic adjustment and also the curve adjustment. Take your time and try to follow my steps. After that, apply the effect, apply a white vignette into the model. And also apply that from the optical. And it OK. Now you can see we just created our whitening effect into the model. And this is the professional look. And if you like to add some of the color correction to make this effect more dramatic, just you can use the hue saturation adjustment. So go to the adjustment layer, and take the hue saturation, apply it to colorize, and adjust the saturation. Now you can change the hue color and apply any kind of color as you want. Now that's okay for me. If you take your time and just add some type into this flyer, you can make this more professional. This is very simple to add some text in the flyer. I am not going to show you all of this one because it's going to take a lot of time and make the tutorial bigger. So I'm just showing only creating the effect. You can just take your time and add the typography to the design. Now if you see the before effect and the after effect is perfect. Now let's see what is we create using this trick. Now, I just show you all the tips and tricks to create the whitening effect in Photoshop. I have shown you all the tricks that I use to create the effect for this kind of flyer. So I hope that you like the tutorial and the tricks about this effect. And if you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. I will try to solve any problem. And hit the like button if you like this tutorial, and do share also the tutorial with your friends so that they can also know about my channel and learn this kind of trick on Photoshop. And if you like, you can check out my channel Showfic Design. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel, not just subscribe, also press the bell icon so that you get all the notifications of my channel and don't miss any chance to learn new tips and tricks. So be sure to subscribe and press the bell icon. So that's it for today, see you in my next tutorial. Till then, bye. And the most important thing, keep learning.